When Bill Walsh Jr.'s father began selling vehicles in the 1960s, customers visiting his Ottawa, Illinois dealership preferred four-door sedans by the big three U.S. automakers, Ford, GM, and Chrysler.
Those vehicles were what everybody talked about.
But today, customers don't just walk into showrooms. They first use the internet to select the vehicles they want. And when they're ready to purchase, Walsh says far fewer customers drive off the lot in new sedans.
25 to 26% of our inventory, new and used, as being sedans. The highest percentage of our inventory and the highest percentage of our sales, therefore, are over 50% being SUVs and crossovers.
In 2019, 7 of the 10 top-selling vehicles sold in the United States were trucks and sport utility vehicles, or SUVs. In the same year, American car sales accounted for 4.7 million units sold overall, a number not seen since the 1950s. It's a dramatic shift, and why manufacturers are abandoning names like the Volkswagen Beetle, Ford Focus, and the hybrid electric Chevrolet Volt. Models you won't see at the 2020 Chicago Auto Show, where trucks and SUVs take the spotlight.
You know, before, sport utilities were body-on-frame, truck-based utilities, poorer fuel economy, rougher riding. That's not the case anymore.
Marketing director Steve Majoros, who represents General Motors' Chevrolet brand, says SUVs now compete with smaller-sized options and fuel efficiency, eliminating a big reason consumers once avoided them. Many SUVs also offer new technology and connectivity options, features consumers want.
If we look back at 2019 for Ford, every 2020 model vehicle that we sold was 100% connected.
Bill Gubing is an enterprise product line manager for Ford, which manufactures the Explorer, one of the best-selling SUVs in America.
I think we're permanently in a versatile vehicle era.
Even so, Ford still offers several sedan options, as does GM. Majoros says Chevrolet is also experiencing a surge of interest in its compact Bolt electric vehicle.
Actually, had our best month ever in January of this year, so it says that there is demand for electrification.
But that demand is hard to see on Walsh's lot.
You still have that range anxiety with electric vehicles.
While Walsh watched the big three U.S. automakers shift away from sedans in recent years, today he oversees an expanded group of 27 franchises that includes foreign automakers like Toyota and Kia, who fill what is now a void in the U.S. sedan market.
There's still sedan buyers out there, and there's still a market for those cars. I don't see them adding anything to the lineup, but I think that those who are committed to the sedan part of their business model will continue to have sedan offerings.
But Walsh believes those offerings will continue to be overshadowed by sales of trucks and SUVs on his lots in the years to come, even as economists predict a continuing slowdown in 2020 of the overall number of vehicles sold in the United States. Kane Fairbaugh, VOA News, Chicago, Illinois.